Hi guys. I think the microphone should be working fine. This is my first time on YouTube, so sorry if something goes wrong. We'll check it out afterwards and fix it. Grab some water, grab your mat, maybe a yoga block if you have it or something to prop yourself up on. Maybe some pillows if you feel like you've been needing them throughout class. Just a couple minutes to get signed on. I have some people asking me how to get on here.
Are you on YouTube now?
I woke up feeling kind of tired today. So sometimes when you start class lying on your back, it just makes you a little bit more tired. Sometimes it'll be nice to start classes either seated, kneeling, or standing. Today we're gonna start them standing. So I'm gonna give everyone like 2 more minutes to get signed on, ask any questions if you have them. Remember to modify as necessary. This class might not be for you if you've got any serious contraindications or injuries, and if anything starts to feel like it's too much, just take a pause, sit in a child's pose, lay on your stomach, on your back, whatever feels best. Cool, got 5 people on YouTube, got a couple people on Facebook, super cool. I think doing this on YouTube will help record my videos so that they're all in one place and just a lot easier to find. And as always, it's a donation-based class, so if you can donate at the end, my Venmo is Vanessa-Ursini. If you need help with spelling, awesome, I can do that. If not, if you're unable to donate today, don't worry about it. Just move with me instead. All right, let's go ahead and start standing. We've got a little bit of arm choreography at the start of this. If it's super confusing for you, you can just let your hands hang out. You can bring your hands behind your head, whatever feels best, arms up to the side. We're gonna start with just some basic squatting. I like to have my feet together for this. You can have your feet at hips width distance, but probably no wider than hips width, okay? So we'll just start with some basic bends and straightens, okay? Watching that the knees stay in the same line as you come down. And when you squat, see if you can keep your heels down. That'll depend on some ankle flexibility. If they need to come up a little bit, that's okay. Just check in with your range. See if you can keep your back lifted, your spine lifted, so that your squat doesn't look like this. That's kind of a gym squat. There's nothing wrong with this, but sometimes a little bit more functional and checking in with flexibility through the ankles here, okay? Now we're gonna add a little side bend to the top of that. So as you straighten, you're gonna take one arm under and side bend towards the arm that's under. Opposite arm just reaches over top like a mermaid. Come back into a squat, arms out to a T, opposite side. Little coordination challenge. Like I said, if this works better for you, you can do that. Just make sure you're getting that nice deep bend and over with the arm. Down. Make sure you're breathing. Watch that if your knees are not touching, that they are not wobbling in or out. I'm gonna just pick up the pace a little bit so you'll bend. This is hopefully gonna get us a little bit of energy and blood flowing before we do a nice, fun little quadruped series today. Nice. A little bit faster, a little bounce in between. Chest is lifted, gaze is lifted the whole time. Nice job. Good, one more each side. And we'll take a little pause. You can shake out the legs. Not super hard, but it'll challenge your brain a little bit too. Keep us mentally stimulated as we all sit at home. For the next one, we're just gonna add a little leg lift to the top of our squat, okay? So let's bring arms out to a T again. They're just gonna hang out here to start. We're gonna squat. As you come up, leg out. Squat, leg out. The range of your leg lift, I'm not as worried about how like high you're going, because see what happens to my torso when I do that. You're gonna squat, you're gonna let the leg lift. Think about lifting just from the leg at the hip joint where the leg meets the hip. When you squat, same idea, try to stay lifted. Out, down, out. Ooh. If you're a little wobbly, a little balance challenge for sure. Now we're gonna add a side bend. Okay, so you squat, we're gonna side bend, squat, side bend, oops, side bend, squat, side bend. So the arm that goes under, you're side bending towards. Cool. Let's try to reverse the arms and see if that's easier. There we go. So you're going away from the arm that's under. That makes more sense. Give that a shot. Nice. So you're adding lots of spine movement. We're moving the arms, getting blood flow through there. You should start to breathe a little bit heavier. Yep, balance challenge is okay. Let's pick up the pace a little bit if you can. Woo. Big breaths. Squat, side bend. Squat, leg out, side bend towards the leg that's reaching out. For two, two, one, one. Good, pause, shake it out. We're gonna do a little, almost like a pelvic circle, imagining you had a hula hoop around you. Hands are gonna come to the hips, feet will be at about hip distance. This is a really fun snowboarding warm-up that I posted a little while ago on my Instagram page that I like to do before I snowboard or ski. You're gonna let the torso start to hinge forward and you're gonna circle around. Spine can come into a little bit of extension as you come back and then you reach forward and up. So it's movement from the hips. There's not a whole lot of rounding or arching in the back. You're just gonna try to let it flow. You let the weight kind of shift back and forth from foot to foot. We're just not coming to something like this, which seems kind of fun, but not today. Okay, keep going. Hinge. Notice if there's a spot that's like, ooh, that's not super easy, or, oh, I really like that. Focus on your positives, not just your negatives, and then switch directions, go the opposite way. Swing the hips around. Legs are mostly straight here. If you need a soft bend in the knee, I'm okay with that. Lots of breath. Rolling around. Notice if one way is a little bit easier for you coordination wise. When you hinge, make sure it's this type of hinge here. It's not rounding and slouching, okay? One more time all the way around. And back to center. So now you guys can face me and do this. I'm gonna do it from the side just so you can see what's happening in my back. For everyone, this range is gonna be a little bit different, okay? So you're gonna have, we're just gonna do single leg kicks out in front of us with that little squat again. So it gives us a little bit of controlled momentum. You're gonna feel a little squat, you're gonna kick the leg forwards. You're gonna feel a little squat, you're gonna kick the leg forward. Sometimes a little movement here in the arms helps with that controlled momentum. Your squat bend is up to you, okay? I want you to focus on that ankle flexibility. If you can keep both ankles down, awesome, both heels down rather, and the spine straight. So if you kick forwards and your spine looks like this, too high, okay? Focus on the movement, still again coming from the hip joint when you kick forwards. So it's not a pelvic curl. You see how that works like that to get me there? Drawing a lot from this area here. I'm gonna be drawing more from here and the hip flexors. Let's keep moving, bending. Kick forwards, arms, kick. Think about lifting from the thigh and maybe a little bit from the back of the thigh where the hamstring lives. Nice. Big breaths. Anytime you guys need a break, take one. If you're looking for a little endurance challenge, try not to take a break. All the options, right? Good. Now hold the left leg up in the air. Find a little bit of balance. If you need to have a soft knee, that's okay. Stand really tall. Okay, now from here, we're gonna do a little lunge forwards. Left leg steps forwards, arms come up, and we're gonna lunge down. Step back, see if you can hover the leg again. Standing single leg balance. Take a gentle step forwards, lunge, come up, and here. Lunge, down. When you come into that lunge, think about the back leg bending straight down towards the floor. And then find your balance to come back. Step, arms can come up, spine stays mostly lifted, and balance. Three, two, one. Let's hold in the lunge just for a moment. See if you can elongate the spine. Step back, same leg. Left leg, if you need to scoot forward, that's fine, is going to come behind you. So you extend the leg back. Now the arms can come up again. What we're gonna do here is bend, same thing, backwards lunge. Now, as you come forwards, you're gonna press into the right leg and do a little teeter-totter, like a little seesaw, okay? Now try to take a gentle step backwards, arms up, let the back leg bend. If your back knee can touch the floor, awesome. If not, let it hover. Good, and back. If you're wobbly and you fall, that's okay. Give yourself a little laugh and get back into it. It's gonna help when we fall and play, be playful with this stuff. It helps trigger that play side of the brain where we're having fun, which I think is important. I think it's important these days is to laugh and up and balance. Next one we're gonna hold. You're gonna come all the way up. You're still standing on your right leg. You're gonna bring your hands down to the floor. If you need a block, you're gonna use a block, okay? It can come on the high side like this if you need it to, or it can be flat. If you wanna be all the way at the floor, that's fine. I'm gonna go with this little horizontal thing here. So keep the chest kind of lifted here, strong in the right leg. If it needs a soft bend, that's okay. Left leg dips down and draws up, down, and up. Good. Use your upper body to help you balance. You can have your weight into that block, okay? You should be feeling your right glute. Little lift of the belly, okay? Lift the leg, hold. Pulse up, five. Keep that leg really straight behind you. Four, three, two, one. See if you can come gently into a lunge and behind you. Go ahead and take a little child's pose, a little stretch. And then we've got a whole other leg to do. If I can remember that whole sequence. Good, go ahead and come up and gently up to standing again. Put your block somewhere nearby so you still have it. We're gonna go back to those single leg kicks just to get realigned. You should feel kind of lopsided right now. One of those glutes should be on fire, okay? Arms can be forwards, little squat, and kick up. Squat, kick up. Squat, think about lifting from the back of the leg to come up. If your leg lifts are getting a little bit smaller, that's also okay. Good. Now, go ahead and keep the left leg planted. Bring the right leg up. We're gonna lunge forwards first, okay? Gentle step and lunge. If you need to scoot that left leg back a little bit, you can. Try to come back up and to balance point, okay? Step forwards, lunge. Do whatever you need to with your hands. If they need to be out to the side, they can be on your hips if you want. Worry about the rest of the body. Back knee reaches down and up. You'll find that one side of your body has way better balance than the other. Just notice it and practice. This is obviously my harder side. Down. Find that straight leg balance if you can. Good. Two more. Controlled momentum. Bend the back knee. Gaze stays up. One more. Hold. Good. Step up. Hover the leg if you can. Now we're going to take that right leg. Step forward on your mat. If you need more mat, you're going to step back. So this right leg is extending now. Okay. We're going to come down into the lunge. Gently come up and tip forwards. Gentle step back. Take your time. Slow movements. Down and up. Forwards. Sometimes bringing the hands back in your teeter-totter will be easier or harder. Try it all. Not a whole lot of rules with this one. Do what feels good. We're just trying to get lots of blood flowing. Get really nice and warmed up before we do this other really fun series today. Reach and lift. Back. Woo. Bend. Up. Hold. Okay. Grab your block. You're going to come forwards. You're going to reach the right leg back. That left leg is as straight as it can be. See if you can get a little longer in the torso. If you look like this and you're super round, see if you can bring your gaze just slightly forwards towards the top of the mat. Reach the back leg back. I'm trying to hold you here so that left leg starts to burn. Lift and lower your right leg. Little toe tap down. And then reach it back up. Like you were just dipping your toes in a really cold pond of water. You don't want them to be there very long. Lift the rib cage up and away from the floor. Now lift the right leg, hold. Super straight leg, reach it farther behind you. Pulses up, up. Six, five, four, three, two, one. Rest. Come all the way down. You can use your block under your head if you need. You can put your block under your tailbone, under your sit bones, whatever helps. Reach it forwards, take a nice big stretch into your child's pose. I hope you are as warm as I am. We are now going to move into a quadruped series. So stacked four-point series. And we're gonna build on this a little bit. I watched a video by my friend Jessica Vallant, who I used to teach with, and she talked a lot about how we build these memories, so we're not introducing constant new things to the brain during a workout. So remember what we're doing as we move along, see what works for you. And like I said, the way that we're gonna build these things, we're gonna start with the most, beginner variation first, and then work up so that it's more advanced. So as we go along and you're like, whoa, that one was way too hard for me, step back one notch or just take a rest, okay? We're gonna find four-point kneeling. Make sure you guys can all still see. Okay, so we're gonna go hands and shoulders aligned, knees right underneath the hips. As per usual, we're gonna take a couple of flex and extends, a little cat-cow. So you're gonna let, I want you to try to start from one end and end at the other. So we're gonna start with the head and neck. You're gonna gaze down and back. The shoulders are gonna round, the belly is gonna lift, and the tailbone is gonna reach down towards the back of the knees.
pause here for a minute. Get nice and round, let your head hang totally heavy. Now, let your tailbone come out. Let your belly come low. Reach the chest forward, almost like you're trying to pull yourself forward on the mat. And round. This can also be done on your forearms. The range will not be as big, okay? Tailbone, feel it undulate through the spine, gazes back. Let's do a couple more here. Rolling forwards, tail is the last thing to come out. And tailbone down, it undulates through the ribs, shoulders. Let your head be totally weightless. Maybe shake it no and yes a couple of times. And then start the head, chest, belly, tail. Okay, come back to a neutral position. Let's start with the left leg, okay? Keep your hands in the same position, knees in the same position if you can. If you need to walk the right knee in a little bit, that's okay. Push into your hands so they're super strong. Gaze is still down, back of the neck is long. Reach your left leg back and see if you can hover it to hip height. Now, bring the knee underneath, round the spine, reach it back out. Extend the spine, so that'll allow you to draw the left leg up a little bit. If that doesn't feel good on your back, neutral is fine, okay? Same thing here. You can pause a little bit sooner with the flexion. You don't have to come all the way in here, but if you can, awesome. See how we're building? We're just adding pieces. Curl and round. Extend and reach. Pull around underneath. Extend and reach. Three more. Lots of breath here. Two. And one, we're gonna hold out there into extension. Here's an optional stretch if you can get to it. Right hand reaches up and back to the foot, okay? If you can make it, that's okay. This is optional stretching for the front line of the body. Gently let go, come back around. Maybe shake out the wrists if you need. And then we'll do the other side. Come back to four-point kneeling, okay? Then when you're ready, watch that your joints are aligned. Push into your hands, really spread your fingers wide. Reach your right leg back. Hover it to hip height if you can. If it's here, cool, not a huge deal. Now round, come in, gaze is back, knee comes underneath the chest. Reach it back and extend gazes forward. Inhale, still feel your chest reach forward like you were gonna try to get your chest past your fingers. Under, and out. Under, this should feel good and challenging. Three more, inhale as you reach. Big exhale, keep pushing through your hands like you were trying to stand and push yourself out of a swimming pool. Two. One, you're gonna reach out and hold, extending the spine, chest is up. If you can, reach the opposite arm up. You're gonna reach over and stretch. Lift the chest, push into your right arm. Extend everything out, back in, and we'll do a little child's pose. We're gonna be onto our hands for a little while here. If you need to be on your fists, hold dumbbells, or come onto a higher surface and be on your forearms, that's okay. You can also just come down to the forearms here. In an aspect, it'll make it a little bit more challenging for this next series. When you are ready, we're gonna come back into quadruped, okay? If you need to walk the hands a little bit further forward, sometimes that makes it easier. You're gonna curl your toes under so they face to your knees, okay? Feel your ribs get really strong. All we're gonna do here is hover the knees. And breathe. Like, I want an inch off the floor if you can. Breathe, hover. If you wanna do one knee at a time, it'll make your pelvis a little off-center, but that's okay. Makes it a little bit easier. Hover, hold, five, four, three, two, one. Little rest. Okay, we're building, okay? So if that was hard enough for you, you stay there, okay? When you're ready, we're gonna hover the knees again, and we're gonna rock back and to starting position. Back, so it's almost like a little squat, pressing into your hands, and then forward, knees are hovering, okay? Okay, knees stay bent when you come back into, it's like a little squat. And then hover. Four more. Push into the hands, chest comes low. And back to starting position. Two. Last one. Hover the knees, see if you can pause for a moment. And rest. Nice job. Now we're going to walk out to a plank and then walk back to the squat. Okay, so we're gonna hold here. We're gonna hover the knees. We're gonna walk one, two, three. We're gonna go one, two, three. So the knees are bent and they can come a little wide, almost like a little frog position. Okay, one, two, three, you should be plank. One, bend the knees, keep the hips low. Back to squat. Out, two, three. Back, see if you can switch which arm you're starting with each time. Let's do two more. Forwards, two, three. Back, one, two, three. Last one, forward. Nice. Now, hold in your plank. We're from here, pressing up to down dog, okay? Get all your wigglies out, let your knees bend, maybe pedal your feet, let your tail shake a little bit, let your chest come low, round, whatever feels good, okay? Now, from here, we are going to do a little, it's almost like a three-legged dog, so we're going back to building onto that quadruped. You're gonna let the leg lift, little extension if you can, and then bring the knee underneath around the spine. Right leg reaches up, down dog, three-legged, come in, round and gaze back. Up and press, nice job, keep your shoulders super strong, round the spine. Three, two, one. Hold the leg up for a minute. If you know how to open the hips, rotate the hips and get a little stretch, that's cool with me. If you want to hang out and just down dog, that's cool. Come back, hover the knee, bring the foot down. Take three steps, straight legs, walk back to a standing, roll down. Here's our little mini rest, okay? Nice job, walk forwards. Three, two, one. Here's our plank, press to down dog. Hold here for just a moment, reset. Take a big deep breath with me, big inhale. Big exhale. Now, when you're ready, left leg comes up and then come under round the spine plank. Reach it up. If you can extend a little bit here, cool. If the hip needs to rotate a little bit, that's fine. In and round, up and back. We're almost done with this quadruped series, I promise. Good. Three. Two, don't forget to get a little bit round in the spine as you bring the knee under. Good, hold the three-legged dog, reach up. If you need to, if you want to, open, let the knee bend, let the hips stack. Good. Come back out to the three-legged dog, downward dog. Now walk back, three, two, one. Keep the feet down, hang out into your roll down. Awesome. We're going to roll up gently. Now keep your weight a little bit biased towards the front of both feet. And think about stacking your bones as you come up. If you need a little soft bend in your knee, awesome. A little bit more challenging to keep your waist straight. Your head is the last thing to come up. Maybe wiggle it up, shake it up a little bit. And then start to roll down again. You're going to nod the chin. You're going to feel the shoulders spread apart, arms dangle. Watch the weight in your feet here. Try to keep your femurs directly on top of your knees. Your knee, a nice big stretch through the back line. And roll up. Take your time. Feel the wheels on the sides of your pelvis. Rotate onto the top of your femurs. Your middle back, or your low back, excuse me, your middle back. Upper back. And head. Two more. Rolling down. When you roll down, think about keeping the back of your neck, back of your throat really wide and long. Should be easy to breathe so you're not jamming your chin to your chest. The tone of your voice should stay about the same the whole time. When you're upside down, it changes a little bit, but it shouldn't sound stressful. It should still be easy to breathe. Now maybe rock back and forth here and here. Your range will be different, okay? It's no big deal. I do not judge flexibility on if you can touch your toes or not, okay? Nice. At the top of this one, let's reach the arms up. Send the weight towards the front of the feet. Extend the spine, just a gentle look up. Come back up. And we're gonna do that two more times. You're gonna reach and lift the sternum bone up. If the arms above the head is too much, bring the hands behind the head and lift. Nice big upper back stretch there. We're gonna come back into a roll down, okay? Let the hands dangle down, okay? I got one more plank that you're gonna walk out into, but roll down to it first, okay? Let your head nod, big breath. Think about lifting your rib cage up and spilling it over. Head is dangling, arms are heavy. Soften the knees if you need to get to the floor. Walk forwards, 3, 2, 1. You have two options here. You can come to the knees, try a tricep push-up to the ground. If you know you can get to the ground from a plank to a tricep push-up, go ahead and do that. Wherever you're at, it could just be based on how you're feeling today, okay? I'm gonna angle the camera just a little bit down because we're gonna be on our tummies for a little while now. I hope you guys are having fun. Okay, so from here, we're gonna do a little prone press-up like we've practiced in the past, okay? Hands to the breastbone, legs are reaching super long behind you, okay? It's just a little movement in the upper body. You're gonna think like someone was pulling your elbows back. You'll feel like your shoulders open, your gaze is towards the floor. If your range is here, awesome, okay? Don't force it. If you come up to the bottom of the ribs and it's just this, your gaze is forward and it's hard to breathe, try not to do that. Let's go in a smaller range where you're still feeling like you're lifting from the chest, less of the neck. The gaze might stay down to help you protect your neck, and that's fine. Use your hands to help pull your body a little bit forward and down. If you've done enough of those, rest with your cheek one to the mat. For the rest of you, let's do three more. Try an inhale to come up, and with your inhale, feel as if there were balloons in the front of your lungs and you're expanding the balloons. Feeling those back muscles, those upper back muscles to middle back kind of fire up and warm up a little bit. Good. Last one. Up. And down. Go ahead and let your cheek rest to the side of the mat. Arms can hang down by your sides. Okay, for our next movement, when we've got our hands on the mat, we're using our hands to help us support ourselves in gravity. What we're gonna do next is gonna clasp the hands behind the back. So now we're not getting the support from the hands anymore. That means we're gonna have to use the strength in the upper back to help us lift. That's how we're building. If you wanna come here and do a few more of those, awesome. If you wanna rest through this next series, that's also okay. So letting the hands just rest one on top of the other, or you can clasp all 10 fingers together, whatever your shoulders will allow. We're gonna reach the arms back to straighten them, and then lift the head, neck, and shoulders. It's like you're trying to drag your fists, have your glutes trying to reach them towards your heels. If you can, come down, rest the cheek. If you're resting on the ground, what I want you to practice is reaching the tailbone away from you. You're gonna flex the knees, 3, 2, 1, and you're gonna reach them to the floor and then let them rest. So if you're not extending your spine, here's where you're at. 3 kicks and a reach, okay? It's not a kick to see how wobbly you can make your body, but how controlled you can make that without unweighting your pelvis and flexing at the knees, okay? For the rest of us, legs are reaching long, hands are clasped, we're gonna reach, gaze forwards. We're creating strength now with the mobility that we've warmed up. Gaze to the opposite cheek. Let's do that two more times. Reach up and extend. Big inhale into the front of the lungs and down and rest. Last one, reach out. Gazes forwards, still arching the upper back, palms and fingers are reaching towards the heels. If you're kicking, last set. Come down, hands can relax by your sides and bring the rest. You're gonna stay on your tummies. I'm just gonna get up to show you what this is gonna look like on your stomach, okay? Little more of a, it's almost a Superman reach. Last time we were behind and we were reaching and extending, okay? Now we're gonna go hands to almost a goalpost position. So they should look like this as you're laying down. Your gaze is gonna go down towards the mat and you're just gonna hover the nose about an inch away from the mat. Then we're gonna practice two things. We're gonna lift into a little extension. Arms are gonna come with us and then we're gonna go back down. If that's where you're at, awesome. Lifting from the sternum bone and up. I'll get down and show you what this looks like again. If you wanna go back to kicks, you can do that too, okay? Lifting and back to the mat. If you wanna increase the challenge there, you're gonna lift the sternum bone into that extension and then you're gonna superwoman or man the arms forwards, back, down, and rest. So on your stomach, that's gonna look like this. Arms at that goalpost position. The head is just hovering off of the ground. You're gonna lift that whole shape up and then you're gonna come back down. Lift and down. If you're ready to increase the challenge, lift, Superman, goalpost, lower. Superman, this is so good for your posture. Come in and lower. Two more. Inhale, up. Exhale, reach. Inhale here, down, and rest. Sit back to a child's pose, even come into a little bit round of a spine after all that really nice extension. Reach the arms long. Prop yourself on a block if you need to. The infamous side plank series is next, okay? All right. If you need a little prop to come up a little higher, you're going to use a block or anything that gives you a little bit of height. If you have a stool, make sure that it's just a sturdy-ish surface. If you don't need a prop, you're going to come knee. Your femur stays right underneath your hip joint, and you're going to reach the top leg out long, okay? Hand is going to come here, and we're going to open the chest. If you have your block, it comes underneath you. This is just gonna give you a little extra height. It'll be a little less strenuous on the shoulder. Wherever you're at today, you're gonna feel length in the upper body, nod the head to the side so it's soft on your neck. You're gonna lift and lower. Leg comes up and down. Up and down. Lift the upper body, keep pressing into the arm. If you need to do this series here, you can. A little bit different. Okay, I'm gonna stay up, up. Now take your hand behind your head. Now we do just a little crunch, okay? Three, two. Now keep your body long, lift your leg, come to quadruped. So pivot on your knee, move your block if you've got one, find it here, lift up, one. Pivot back to your side position. Let's just stretch, okay? Push into your arms, side body stretch. Leg is grounded and rooted. It's good, come up and switch sides. You can continue to face me if that's helpful. And then using your block or just hand on the mat, align your femur bone right underneath your hip to start. Reach your opposite leg out so you are grounded. And then come down, find either the mat, your block, or your forearm, okay? Now, hand can go wherever. Hand behind the head will help find some alignment in the upper body. Little nod to the head and lift.
Notice which side is a little bit tougher than the other. Up. Up. See if you can get a little longer in the upper body and breathe. Adding a little side bend as the leg comes up. Here. Building. Draw the ribs back, belly button in a little bit. Three, two, one. Let the body come out. Leg stays up. Little pulses. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Rotate forwards. Find your quadruped. You're on your right knee. Your left leg is lifting behind you. Neutral spine. Pulse from your hamstring. Kind of right where your hamstring and your glute meet. Keep the ribs lifted for three, two, one. Come down. Pivot back to your side bend. Back onto your single arm and stretch. Push in your right arm so it's like you're trying to arc your ribs up and away from the floor. And just reach. Really nice. Okay, let's come to high kneeling. If you need pads under your knees, go for it. If you need, we're gonna be coming from high kneeling to low kneeling. If you've got anything going on and you want a little bit of support underneath your pelvis or your sacrum, you can with a block or a pillow, something folded, whatever you've got at home. Okay, so you're starting high kneeling. We're gonna come down into a little squat. Arms are up. We're gonna reach up and come forwards. Little bit of what we did in the beginning with the squats. Now we're on the knees. Little bit different emphasis. See if you can feel which one is easier for you. We're down and we're up. We're down, we're up. Just trying to keep blood flowing. And reach. Nice job, you guys. Let's go here, here, here. Four. Three, two, one. Go ahead and sit all the way into your bottom. Keep your block or your prop if you need it for legs outstretched. Here. Okay. If you need this, it's because you can't sit in an upright position. If you need pillows, that's fine. If you want to just bend the knees, that's okay too. So they're in this diamond position in front of you to sit tall and create length here. Okay. If you need something bigger than a block, that's okay too. Much more worried about what's happening in your spine. If your legs are outstretched, they're about the width of the mat. Hands are going to come behind the head. Okay. Feel your hands clasped together and then almost push into your hands with your head and a little bit vice versa. That should help you lift through the chest a little bit. Okay. Now from here, little rotation, okay? Exhale, inhale to center. Opposite side, inhale to center, sit tall, exhale, rotate. Inhale, exhale. Good, watch that you're keeping both sit bones weighted and the chin should be about level with the floor the whole time. Maybe even just a little nod down with the chin. Good. Now, rotate, hold. Arms out. Hands back. Back to center. Exhale, twist. Arms out. Back to center. Twist. Arms. Center. Arms as you rotate, so it's a little bit more fluid now. Back. Should feel maybe a little bit of those postural nerves working again. Okay, now hold, round forwards, up, stay here one more time. Nod the chin, your gaze is towards the camera. Back arm, check out what's happening in my hand. My thumb is down like I'm giving a thumbs down behind me. Palm is towards the camera, thumb is up on my front arm. Come up to center, rotate, two folds here. Arm is back, thumb is down, opposite arm forwards, and up, two times. Okay, so you're reaching towards your opposite leg. Back to center, twist.
One,
two. Back to center. Rotate. Reach up. Reach. One more time to each side. I'm feeling more energized. I hope you guys are too. Exhale, twist. Rotate up and down, up and relax. Go ahead and come off of your block if you're on one. Roll downs are next. Reach forward, sit as tall as you can in the spine. If you need to bend the knees, great. If you want to sit here, cool. Reach forwards, lift up. We're gonna control low down, lower down to the mat, okay? Starting with the pelvis, the heels will start to drag along the mat. See if you can keep them on the mat the whole time. Roll down, reach all the way above your head. Give yourself a nice big stretch. Maybe make yourself longer on your mat, like you could touch all four corners. If you're tall enough, you might be able to do that already. Arms up to the ceiling. Inhale, nod the chin, curl up. Use your breath, come to the top, stretch it forward. If you need to bend your knees, great. If not, stretch, really get that long back line stretch. Restack the bones. Up and roll down. Pelvis first, take your time, gazes forwards as long as it can be. And then once the shoulder blades touch, the arms come up, the gaze comes up, and we're on the ground. Curling up, let's do two more there. Use your breath, try not to use momentum. If you find a spot where you feel like you're heave-hoeing yourself up, maybe only go down about halfway and then come back up and just work to it, okay? Roll down, take your time. Arms up. And to the top. One last time, stretch it forward. And elongate, bend your knees, feet flat. We're gonna go halfway down on this one, okay? So sit tall, round through the spine like you're trying to create a really long capital C shape in your body, okay? We're gonna march the legs here, okay? One leg up. If you have a prop, if you have a ball and you'd like a little support or anything underneath your low back, maybe even a foam roller to come here and to do your marches like this, this is just gonna give you a lot more support through your back so that you're your abdominals can properly work. Here, use it. Okay, so you're here and here. Okay, you're gonna go one leg up and down for more challenge. See if you can lower a little bit more, keeping the stress out of the neck. It kind of feels like it's working a little bit, but not strenuous. Should be easy to breathe. If just holding is hard enough, awesome. If you want more of a challenge, lift one leg up. See if you can balance on the sacrum, lift the other leg up. Balance, hold, breathe. One leg down, then the other. Sit up tall, maybe a little stretch forwards, maybe a little hug. Okay, from here, we're gonna roll back about halfway. One more set here, similar to what we've done before. Arms are gonna come up. Rotate towards me. Arms up, rotate away. Good. Try to keep the head on the same swivel so your chin stays level with the floor. If you're feeling this in the front of the hips, you've got super grippy hip flexors, try squeezing a ball or pressing out into something like a band or a circle. Might have given me a little trouble today, so I'm gonna squeeze the ball. Helps draw them from my inner thighs and stay out of my hip flexors. Up. Twist, one more to each side. Twist, up, last one. Sit all the way up. Woo! Get rid of your ball. Next series is a little single leg stretch, okay? Left leg reaches long, right leg stays in front of you. You're gonna take your right hand onto the bottom of your right, oh no, I lied. Take your right hand onto your ankle, okay? The outside of your bent leg. take your other hand across and hug it to the bottom of your kneecap, okay? Does that make sense? If not, it's not a huge deal, okay? We're gonna roll down with control to a single leg stretch. When you're ready, roll back. Pause at the tips of your shoulder blades, okay? So you're in thoracic flexion. If you need to rest your head due to an injury, lower it down or support yourself on a ball again. If you're here, we're gonna switch. So the outside hand comes across to under the knee. The outside hand goes to the ankle. Switch, switch. Your torso is still. Keep your gaze forwards. Chin is down. If you want a little pulse, pulse, you can. Pulse, pulse. When you're here, see if you can push energetically into your shin and then switch sides. Maybe that helps you come up another inch and we go across. Maybe a little bit faster. 10 more seconds. Wherever you're at, pulses, head down, whatever. Try to stay with me. 4, 3, 2, 1. Outstretch everything. Whew, rest. Awesome. Okay, for the little oblique challenge next, crisscross. You're gonna come hands, let's go knees into tabletop. We're gonna take hands behind the head, we're gonna curl up. Okay, now right elbow, left knee, right leg outstretches. Come across center, switch. So it's opposite elbow, opposite knee. Notice that when I'm in my rotation, I'm not curling forwards and really reaching for the knee. I want you to think about pivoting on the tips of the shoulder blades to do this instead of here. This isn't really working anything, but up and up. So you're still in that forward flexion. If you want to pulse, pulse, cool, pulse, pulse. Try not to pull and yank on your head. If you look like this and it's just your neck up, none of that, okay? Try to just lower the head down and work on the legs if you can. If you need a little help, exhale, get up to the tips of the shoulder blades. Two more on each side. And rest. Oh my gosh, those are so hard for me. Reach out, stretch everything up and over. Nice job. Okay, last set of abdominal work. We're gonna curl up. We're not gonna support the head and the hands if you can, okay? One leg comes up, clasp the back of the thighs. Here's where you get your help. You're not up like this, okay? We're still trying to hang out at the tips of the shoulder blades. So it's thoracic flexion, okay? Hover the opposite leg. Remember, we're building, so if one of the other moves works better for you, awesome. The hands and the thighs to help you gain a little bit extra height. Chin is down, soften through the neck. Think about gaining. We're gonna work on rolling like a ball next, okay? So to do that, we're gonna, however you need to, just go ahead and rock yourself up to seated. Now, if you can, we're gonna hover the knees. You're gonna clasp the hands around the shins. Now remember, when we roll like a ball, still aiming for the back of the shoulder blades, we're not rolling onto the neck, okay? So you're coming here and here, bones the whole time. Roll back and forth. Notice that there is no kersplat when I'm rolling down because I'm staying round, okay? Round and up. It is a little bit of momentum, but it's controlled momentum, okay? Inhale back. Exhale, forwards. Heels stay in the same position, close to the sit bones, best you can. 3, 2, 1. Nice, however you need to get there, roll. Knees and feet about hip distance apart, arms long by your sides, okay? Roll through the pelvis, still up into a bridge. Pause at the top, let's just hang on in the bridge for a second. Find your feet into the ground. Take a couple of deep breaths. Pull the heels back towards the sit bones gently.
And then let's lower down. And roll up. And down. Little break from all that fast-paced work that we were doing. Checking in and noticing if you've done a few of these classes with me, or just how you felt from the beginning to the end, if you're feeling looser, more energized, your heart's starting to calm down, your spine should feel nice and warmed up by now. Let's hold in the bridge. Take your arms so that your arms are straight, and then lower through your spine. It might not seem like it, but this will be a little bit more challenging. Keeping the knees in the same line. Imagine you had a ball in between your knees. You didn't want to drop the ball, you want to pop the ball. Let's say it's a balloon. Reach and feel this nice big stretch when your arms are overhead. You might feel a stretch to the back of the shoulders. If you hate this, go ahead and put your arms by your sides. Let's hold in the bridge, arms up towards the ceiling, and then one arm comes up, the other arm reaches back. Keep your hips lifted, reach opposite side. Up and switch. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Up and lower. Go ahead and let your knees rock from side to side here. Will you turn the music up?
Off.
And then we're gonna let the legs outstretch. Support your head with a pillow if you need to. We're going to let the arms reach long by your sides. Now that we're nice and supine on the floor, just take a couple of really deep, nourishing breaths. That was a lot of work, one of the faster paced videos that I've done. And just check in. Let your feet be heavy. Almost they'll just feel like they fall out towards either side. Check in with your legs. Maybe give them a couple of pats into the floor. And then let them relax. Check in with your hips, the back, the front, side to side. Maybe a couple of little pelvic tilts like we've practiced before. And then find a place of rest and ease. Take your hands to your rib cage. Inhale into your hands, feeling the ribs expand outwards. Big exhale. Relax. Big inhale again, left to right into the ribs. Bring one hand to your heart, the other to your belly. See if you can expand your breath into both hands. Breathing up and down. Feeling the heart rate soften. Reach the arms out, palms facing whichever way feels more natural. Little wiggle of the shoulders here, up and down. Maybe shrug them up towards your ears, let them relax. Maybe you let your upper back arch a little bit, let it relax. Whatever feels good, just drawing awareness to each kind of zone in the body. Find a place of ease through your upper body, and then maybe let your head rock from side to side. Maybe nod your chin up and down. Now let everything and more little inhale and exhale at your own pace. Roll yourself to one side or the other. And then gently push yourself up to seated. That is class for today. If you stuck through that whole thing, awesome. It was not easy. Trying to talk through it is also really challenging for me. I'm still very new at these videos. Thanks for the inspirations for my classes today. Thanks for joining me. This will be recorded on YouTube. I'll repost it on Facebook.
let me know if you have any questions, concerns, comments. I really, really appreciate your guys' support throughout this time, even if you're just joining me on the mat and breathing with me or just watching me. That's cool too. I miss you guys so much. I love you, and I hope I get to hug all of you really soon.